Hello, Bob Sullivan Nation. Thank you for joining me and my guest for the first ever interview, courtesy of the Bob Sullivan Show. This will we will be recording here Monday on in a beautiful setting here in Frost Studios, off of Rainwood Road. I'm being joined today by a friend and fellow colleague in the business, Matt Shepard. Welcome to the show, Matt.
Well, great to be here. Hey, thanks for Bob Sullivan Nation.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
Is that going to be a every interview, every segment kind of deal is Bob Sullivan Nation? Or how would you come up with that?
Not sure where I'm going with it.
I really haven't heard much about that, so that kind of caught me by surprise, but I like it. Bob Sullivan Nation.
Frankly, I don't think there is a Bob Sullivan Nation.
I'm
going to address them as that. Well, what should we call it first? Is it the Bob Sullivan forced following as of right now? And then if people start joining by their own free will, can it become Bob Sullivan Nation then?
I think that would clarify as a nation, yeah. I mean, you know, sports nation on...
Yeah.
Yes, they just kind of throw it out there. I mean, they throw it out there, whoever watches, so...
Well, they went off right off the bat with sports nation. I don't think they were, like, captured it until Michelle Beadle started showing more cleavage, you know?
That's a good point.
So once I...
I'm not showing more cleavage, though. Thank God we're not doing video. I'm not showing cleavage, though.
Well, it's good for the audience that we're not doing video, too.
You don't have any more tuners. You don't want to get anybody else joining in anymore.
No. And we might get sued for putting sexually explicit content on the internet, or on Facebook, for sure.
Yeah, as scary as it might seem. But,
okay. Yeah, so our hands will be on the table for this interview. Matt's hands may be flailing around during some of his rants and tirades here, but bear with us through these first couple shows. Give it a couple shows. If you don't like it, stick around for a couple more shows. If you still don't like it, you've made it through four shows already, then... just stick it out. I mean, there's a good chance this show's going to get canceled anyway, so just bear with us. What do we establish it as? Bob Sullivan's Force Following?
Bob Sullivan's Force Nation, presented by Bob Sullivan Nation, I think is what it is.
Okay, right.
Can I say something real quick?
Go ahead.
Have you been watching these bowl games? Bowl games?
Not at all.
God. Yeah, me neither. You can't. I mean, a couple days ago I'm watching Wake Forest and, what was it, Mississippi State? It's like, how can you watch this?
It's not because I have time, because I do. It's because I don't. I don't know. I can't turn it on. I'm watching. This year, I have followed less football than in my entire life. Football's, I mean, NBA is number one, which I'm gonna get crap for, but it's always been number one. Football, baseball have been kind of a tied number two. With football, I mean, I haven't even been dedicated on Sundays, really. Like, the Monday night games, how does Jacksonville get as many primetime games as they got this year? And college football, aside from the Saturday night games, Big Ten was terrible. Pac-12 was unwatchable, aside from a couple Oregon, Stanford, and USC games. Big 12 was watchable. Big Ten, unreal. Why are there no night games at the end of the season? It's like... Does everybody go to bed at 5 o'clock in Big Ten fan country? Like, what the hell?
This year, they finally started playing night games. I mean, shit, you can go back 3-4 years ago, every Big Ten game was at 11. Mm-hmm. And that was a little change for Nebraska fans this year. But, I mean, and you're kind of seeing Big Ten football put on display during the bowl season.
How pathetic has the Nebraska fan base gotten, really? As far as... I was watching games just at random this year. Virginia Tech, what have they... They haven't won as many championships as... I don't even know if they've won a national championship. That crowd, it was nuts for that Miami game. That was one of the best atmospheres I've ever seen. I've never seen an atmosphere like that in a Nebraska game. Part of it has to do with... I think Osborne and some other old person around the town there... Him and Charlie McBride buy two school buses, go pick up two elderly retirement homes.
Yeah, go to Newcastle and Omaha. Swing by a couple of different ones in Lincoln.
And then, let's ship all the students to the top.
Well,
why do you do that?
Well, this is a topic, God, I think it was last year or 2 years ago, where you had older people complaining, like, on air, on message boards. I mean, yeah, they're on message boards, too. They're complaining about, you know, you got to be sitting down during these football games. You got to be sitting. It's like, all right, I mean.
It's the same thing at the Creighton games.
Oh, yeah.
And is there a stupider place to complain about people standing up than a Creighton game? Because you're not really the only place that's standing is the student section. That's, what, five rows deep?
Right.
And the rest of the people are either drinking wine, eating cheese, or both. Or their kids are running around. I mean,
they can get like one of those.
I love Creighton. I'm losing it with Nebraska, but it's really.
They should get one of those play places like they have in McDonald's at those Creighton games.
One of the what?
Like, oh, not play places like a McDonald's. Yeah. They should get one of those at the Creighton games. To contain, I know what you're saying. There are so many. I mean, even like, you know, fifth, sixth, seventh graders just run around too. Just, you know, hey, I went to the Creighton game.
Just have a section dedicated to. Like, okay, you got your elderly people up here. You got your kids that like to run around in this section. So, you know, if you're a diehard fan, you're not going to go sit in that section with those kids who are talking about God knows what. And the elderly people, I'll tell you what. Something that really bothers me. I'm sitting at a Creighton game. Let's see. That would have been the Campbell game. So about 3 weeks ago. I'm sitting in front of this old bag who's like 85 years old. So keep in mind, this woman has seen Bill Russell, would have seen Bill Russell, Wilt Chamberlain, and Magic, Bird, Jordan. It's not like she would have no basketball access at all in her lifetime. Well, I'm sitting in front of her. I'm losing my goddamn mind. I'm sitting there. She's raving about Creighton like, oh my God, Doug McDermott, he is incredible. Not taking anything away from Doug McDermott. Yeah, he's a great player, but holy crap. How can, and she's like, his dad must be so proud of him. He's going to be such a great player at the next level. My, this team is just so great. All right, first of all, lady, have you ever been to a basketball game? Because this isn't the most impressive product on the floor. Believe me, I wouldn't even consider it the most impressive product Creighton's really put out there.
It's the most impressive product that's in the state of Nebraska.
Yeah.
As much as that pains me to say.
Yeah, except for Wayne State softball. Let's not forget about Wayne State softball here.
Okay.
It's the second most exciting. It's first for basketball, second overall in sports.
Yeah.
Well, maybe Nighthawks, too. But
what about your hockey team?
The Lancers?
No, your other one.
The Mavs?
What's that new? Oh, no, indoor soccer team.
Oh, the Vipers.
Vipers, your soccer team, yeah.
My God. Well, I'm sad to say this, but my passion for indoor soccer, it reached a fever pitch last year. And they didn't have a season this year because they joined a new league. And there was a conflict over the renting out the Civic because I'm guessing that they couldn't afford it. And so the dispute turned into them not being allowed to play the Civic. Hence, they canceled the season. Now it doesn't look it doesn't look too good for them. What I'm hoping for is they're going to I hope they move into that 4,000-seater in Rawlston. They're open for the Lancers. I hope that them, the Beef, and the Lancers have their little niche there. And I think you could really grow around that audience because that's the same audience that goes to the Storm Chasers games. Yeah, you can get your rich people from, what is it, like Gretna area. That's not too far away from Gretna. You don't. Quest Center area or CenturyLink isn't bad. But Civic, don't ask me to walk down there after a game alone because there's too many dark alleys down there, and I don't know who's holding the knife or who's holding the gun down there.
I'm not going to lie. I didn't think that me bringing up, just kind of mentioning a Vipers reference, but I sent you on a little, tour of future Vipers experiences. But
well, I love them, and I have a T-shirt, and if this show takes off, the first soccer player to make an appearance on the show, God willing, is going to be a Vipers player.
If you can name one.
Well, I can't right off the top of my head, but I'm sure if I went to their website from last year, I could pronounce a couple of their names.
That'd be good. That's one thing of soccer I have a problem with, is even, you know, pronouncing the names, you see.
Yeah, but It's not a good sport. And the indoor thing, at least it adds some scoring.
Exactly.
There's zero. I'm watching a World Cup game, and I like it. I will watch the World Cup, but don't try. It's being forced down our throats. It's the soccer thing. Like,
I did watch the Creighton, I guess the second half of the Creighton Charlotte game, the Final Four game that ended up going to the shootout.
Was that who did they play? It was like
Charlotte.
Yeah.
I mean, you could just tell towards the end of that second half or whatever, they were just, Charlotte was playing for the. They neither had any chances in those penalty kicks or whatever the hell that is, and they just kind of played defense and just kind of hung back. But
what do you think the best overtime is as far as sports go?
Overtime, so extra innings doesn't count. I mean, finishing the game
that
I mean,
counts.
I'd say you just say extra innings in baseball, but I mean, as far as football, I think NFL's got it. I mean.
I'd prefer the style for all football to go to the first. If you score a touchdown, game over.
So the new NFL playoff.
Yeah. That should just apply all football.
Field goal, the other guys get the other guys get a shot.
Except for, I will say that high school overtime when
what's that?
Ron Colley played Gretna when they went to overtime in 03. They went to that overtime. They started at the 10-yard line because. Asking a high school team to go 25 yards, especially a Ron Colley team. I mean, imagine that now.
Just high school football in general, Nebraska high school football.
That's a disaster. But the 10-yard with them, great. What about Canadian football? Do you like the big end zone, or do you think that's unnecessary?
The Canadians just had to do something different, I guess, make them feel different. But
kind of like. Now they just decide to be a worse country than the United States. I mean, they just do everything worse up there.
America Junior.
No offense to Canadian listeners out there, but there needs to be a
big Jason Bay fan, by the way. I don't want to throw anything against Jason Bay, the Canadian.
Yeah, right.
Play for the New York Mets, but
or Jahan Manigault from
Great guy. Met him a couple. I mean, great guy, really great guy.
Yeah, Matt's got some celebrity. Who else have you introduced yourself to? That's a celebrity. I mean, I know Dicker Dean.
Yeah, he's a...
Are you as outgoing as Dicker Dean when it comes to introducing yourself to celebrities?
Not quite. I mean, I saw, like, Woody Williams walking around College World Series. Ooh. You see, I just kind of pointed myself on him, shook his hand and stuff. But, I mean, Woody Williams, the guy he was with, no surprise, just because Woody had his hair sticking up and just looked homeless is what his buddy said. That's besides the point.
Isn't it really great when you run into some pro athlete or something who's trying to look like trying to cover up that they're out in public so they don't get run into. And then you run into them and then you're like, hey, I did this with Darren Dreyfuss when I was in St. Louis.
Darren Dreyfuss?
I
saw him at a grand slam, by the way, at Dodger Stadium.
Oh, Chavez Ravine. All right.
Yeah.
We got Darren Matt's, Dreyfuss. We got Matt's new show name. Matt of Chavez Ravine.
Oh, no. I got to prove the name of...
Well, we'll figure that out. But let's get on to the main focus of why I had you on here. I mean...
I don't even know what the main focus is. What'd you bring me on here for?
I don't know. I'm
very versatile.
Wanted those sexy locks of red on the show. I know you guys can't see it, but they're flowing today. And
by the way,
he's wearing his Suck for Luck t-shirt. When did you get that?
Dicker Dean got it for me. Dicker Dean, my father, got it for me. He went online. He thought it was pretty funny. What's this website say?
Sports Crack.
Okay, Sports Crack. Okay, so he got this Suck for Luck shirt for me, and it was like for a Christmas gift, and I was like, all right, that's good. I go, all they had to do was lose, or the Rams had to win, obviously, since we already know what happened. Colts lost, so I could wear it for the rest of my life, hopefully. But he got a couple of different shirts. The one he got himself says, sorry, ladies, the shirt is staying on or something.
Oh, nice.
And that's classic Dicker Dean. But, I got my Suck for Luck shirt. So
what will you do? Okay, say the Colts trade the number one pick. Andrew Luck comes out. You trade it to, the Jets.
Okay.
You trade it to the Jets. The Jets suck next year because they got Mark DeSanchez.
I think they're done with him, by the way. I think they're throwing the towel with him. I think they're moving on. They're going to try to anyway.
I think they should. Do you?
Yes.
I mean,
they trade up for him. They had to trade up to like three, didn't they?
They trade up to five, I think. But you talk about
five. Okay.
You talk about more undeserved attention for a quarterback.
Oh man! Like, well, when you play at the USC, you know,
1 year.
The college, as far as colleges go, then you go to New York. I mean, he got
beat out by John David Booty though.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, he played in the NFL a little bit.
Yeah, he was the Sean Salisbury of the NFL. When are we going to see his speaking?
All right,
John Booty going to be on TV? We need his southern southern twang, because that does not fit USC.
Hell, he might have been by now. Who knows? With all these Fox Sports Network different.
Kind of... you talk about a different breed from there. I mean, you got Carson Palmer, who's clearly an asshole. You got Matt Leiner taking pictures with all the ladies. You know,
good for him, I guess. He likes the beer bong.
Yeah, he likes.
Good for him, I guess.
He likes the ladies. He likes to party it up.
Yeah.
Likes getting in hot tubs. Now, I can't blame the fella. If this show goes gangbusters on ratings, there's going to be a Bob Sullivan picture in a hot tub with some hot women. Trust me. Mark my words. Any groupies are accepted. Second of all, let's go on to this John David Booty. Then you got Sanchez after Booty.
Yeah.
Who's this Southern California kid who, I'd assume so. At least somewhat California. He goes to New York. I mean, he's cocky. He's doing GQ. He's dating like some 19-year-old chick. John David Booty, do you think he's a number one first-round pick if he decides to act that way and be the Joe Cool like those three did?
I don't think so. I mean, he has regressed every year. I mean, I think last year, about a quarter through the, maybe last year he was doing, he was showing signs of getting better, but this year he took four steps back at least.
Yeah.
And Brian Schottenheimer,
He is partially to blame.
Partially. I mean, it's run. I mean, screen pass.
Well, it's almost like Nebraska.
Yeah. Yeah.
Except
but,
for with maybe a little bit better. And would you say Sanchez is a better passer than Taylor Martinez?
At least 25 times better than Taylor Martinez. Yeah.
That's not. I don't know.
He's not even close, unfortunately. Yeah, okay. But anyway, so you were talking about so
Peyton. Let's say Luck gets the first round. Their first overall pick gets traded to somebody stupid like the Jets, and you get a first round next year.
There's this year,
and then like two second round or high round picks.
Yeah.
What do you do with this Suck for Luck T-shirt if you wind up with Matt Barkley?
Do
you do like a.
Like a catchphrase for Barkley?
Yeah, like, let the Jets fret for Bark or something like that. So you can, you're going to have a good season next year if Peyton comes back.
Who knows what that, that's a different, I mean, who knows what that thing, I mean, those neck injuries with that surgery, who knows? I mean, he was still having pain throwing. I mean, I remember, there's a question about him coming back for the, for the first weekend, for the first game, and then obviously that didn't happen. Then, after he missed a couple of games, he said, well, we'll be back in, he'll be back in December.
Mm-hmm.
And he's still not even
100%
wearing pads or not even,
not even wearing,
was he wearing pads or
not even
practice?
Wearing a headset for the games. Like,
he had to take the headset
what
off.
What selfish SOB.
You see those sunglasses he rocks? God, could he
Are they better than Tony Sperano's?
Could Peyton act any more like a mid-50s, 55-year-old guy, on the golf course with those glasses. I mean, man.
If he adds the Hawaiian shirt, I think he's got it.
Well, shit, we'll see him at the Pro Bowl, maybe, I guess, if Eli goes down, but.
Who would you not mind? So we established that there's a possibility they trade Luck, but there's probably the possibility that they trade Peyton. What do you trade in that situation? Because You can get a good quarterback next year anyway. And if you trade Peyton, you're going to get some good draft picks.
You're going to – if they decide to go the Luck route, if they don't trade that – according to their owner, Jim Irsay, he's been saying along, I know you can totally take some people at their words, but he said they're going to take Luck and sit on that. And he's pretty blind about it. He thinks they're gonna he's gonna keep both of them at the same time. But I know Peyton's, you know what, 30? He'll be 36, and
I don't get. There's talk like they can't, they wouldn't be able to coexist, which I don't. The whole Mac or Curtis Painter thing makes me consider that you're gonna want to get rid of one of them, because I just saw some stat or somebody was talking about how Peyton took 100% of the snaps at practices.
Yeah. Yes.
Where's the scout team on this? Like, why isn't Curtis Painter practicing, getting reps? I mean, for them to just commit 100% to Peyton Manning, yeah. I get, but injuries happen. I mean, you can't count on a guy being Brett Favre.
I know, yeah. First of all, unfortunately, it wasn't even a football injury.
Well, that's like banking on the lottery.
Well, let's be honest, though. Even if Curtis Painter does get the normal snaps at backup gets, do you think he's going to lead him to 10 wins in a playoff appearance if Peyton goes down?
No.
I mean, I don't think it matters. And, you know, it kind of worked out for him that they didn't win five games and go average and win five games and get a number five pick and draft a good college player, but nothing that's going to, you know, fortunately NFL, you know, you need a quarterback. You can't have average quarterback play.
Well, and their whole thing has been, I mean, this team, it has been shown that it's not a good team.
No.
And it's incredible the things Peyton was able to do as far as everybody says, oh, well, Peyton doesn't play special teams and he doesn't play defense. Okay, but you're not going to have to punt as much as you had to. You're not going to have to kick as many field goals.
Or as long as field goals. Right. Or as long.
Peyton controls time of possession at will.
Yep.
The best at that in football history.
You're going to be putting up points.
Put up more points.
That
defense is sitting on the bench more than they are. Freeney and Mathis, they had to do a rotation where, at times, neither one of them was on the field.
No.
And you didn't have to do that when Peyton
never,
was around. That never happened.
I never remember that happening. I mean, yes, they like all defensive ends that speed, you know, pass rushers, yeah, they come out every once in a while. They don't play every first down. Or they don't play every second and two. But, right. No, I mean, like, no, just, Peyton's going to put up points, like you said, and, you know, regardless. And that defense is built to rush the passer and, you know, get after. And, you know, how many times you see, you know, teams just, you know, that's been the strategy. Run, run, run. You see, you know, Jaguars with Jones, Drew, Texans with Foster.
It doesn't.
Titans with Chris Johnson and...
Well, they attempt to run with Chris Johnson.
Yeah.
If I'm a GM of an NBA team or an NFL team, I'm never paying a running back ever.
Never. 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 You see Clinton Portis with that trade? Yeah,
At least he had a solid career after the contract. Like, it wasn't great. He's not a Hall of... Well, he's up there in all-time rushing yards. I'd say he's a Hall of Famer, but... Chris Johnson and Adrian Peterson. Peterson's going to be out part of next year with that knee injury.
Yeah.
If he comes back too early, you got the running back version of Dante Culpepper. And Chris Johnson, I mean, what you pay those guys, those are the most self... Aside from wide receiver, that's the most self-centered position on the field.
Mm-hmm.
And as soon as those guys get paid, I mean, the lockout included killed those guys.
Right. Yeah, you never really... I mean... And they're even talking about, unless you have like an Adrian Peterson or a Trent Richardson this year out of Alabama, right. you don't even want to take a running back in the first round. You see less and less running backs drafted in the first round now.
Right.
And you just see guys getting dropped, and I wouldn't do it either. I mean, you see so many teams using two. Now this year you see more, like you said, with the lockout, having three running backs at a time. You saw the Steelers do that. You didn't know he was going to get the ball.
Right.
Wally Moore, Isaac Redmond, Mendenhall. I mean,
did Mendenhall have a decent year this year?
Yeah.
That surprises me, because I think he had like over 375 rushing attempts last year.
Yeah, they pounded the rock.
Yeah. After, like, you look through history, guys after a season, like 300 plus carries, they die.
Yes.
It's like, I mean, it's one of the, I mean, that's a guarantee no take on a fantasy football team, and nobody touched Mendenhall because of that. And then, I mean, he was surprised. He was decent. He was probably better than Johnson fantasy wise.
Oh, yeah. I know. You know who really dropped off was, you know, Michael Turner when he's at the Chargers. They, you know, he went to the Falcons and, you know, they pounded and pounded upon him. He had close to 2,000 yards, I think. I mean, he was up 1,800, 1,600, something like that. And next, in all those carries, I don't know the exact number, but yeah, the next year he had a real downfall. I mean, big dramatic takeoff. And this year he's kind of back up to, he did, you know, he eclipsed what he did last year. But yeah, you can tell that just.
Who do you think the Colts, what direction should the Colts go coaching wise? I think they got to get rid of, I think Caldwell is, he's not a coach. He's an assistant.
Yeah.
Maybe a,
yes.
He's not
a head coach.
He's about
coach.
Like Jackie Moon in semi-pro as far as how much coaching he does.
Except for without the personality.
Without the personality. And
I like him just because he's been around the Colts organization for how long, but I don't think I'm with you. I don't think he's a head man. And
and aside from Tony,
what really set me off was last year in the playoff game when they lost to the Jets. That timeout
right.
he used. It's like, and even so, they even showed Peyton on the sideline. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
And that's what it was. Colts deserve to win that game anyway. But I think especially if they want to go the direction of Andrew Luck and they want to trade Peyton or do whatever with Peyton, you got to get a new head man, especially when you got their old coordinator that left. They got brought Larry Coyer on the defensive side a couple years ago, and their old. I mean, they've had a bunch of just staff changes since Dungy left, and especially if you go Luck, you got to change. I think
if you get rid of Caldwell, do you get rid of Peyton with Caldwell?
I think it's the other
way. If you keep Caldwell, do you do with Peyton? Either do you think both of them have to go? One or the other, or both?
I think Caldwell's going to be gone no matter what. But if they haven't decided yet, and they decide on like the Luck Peyton thing, I think you start fresh no matter what at the coaching at the head coach position with Luck. You know, if they say new GM, you get new GMs and stuff. Same thing with baseball. You get new GMs, you get a new coach. You get a new coach in football, or you get a new quarterback in football. You usually get a new coach, and they wait.
Well, look at Wisenhunt.
Yeah,
he wasn't going to take a chance on Pretty Boy. Matt Leiner. No. Matt Leiner, if you're listening, I love you, buddy. Welcome on the show anytime.
But thanks for listening, too.
Thanks for listening. Matt Leiner is going to listen to this show. You're welcome on the show anytime, but he actually showed that before he got injured, that like 67 seconds, he showed like he could play a quarterback.
The like two quarters he played, he looked good. He looked good, and you know, I was kind of joking around about him, but you know, he looks like Tom Brady compared to TJ. And I like TJ Yates, but yeah, he goes down too. And Jake DeLome came in. He's actually
looked good.
DeLome?
Yeah.
Besides from you see that touchdown drive they went on?
Yeah, until the 2-point conversion, that looked like the Jake DeLome of Carolina Panthers, the mediocre get-it-done quarterback.
Yeah.
Not the flailing, throwing interceptions left and right, fumbling the ball. Jake DeLome that we came to know and love
right.
at the end of his Panthers-Browns days.
Those Browns days were bad. I forget.
Who did he get when you get replaced by Seneca Wallace?
Yeah,
retirement's knocking at the door.
You got different issues. That's why that's why you just got signed by the Texans. That's why I think Houston's one and done.
Yeah.
If Schaub was around, the way they ran.
Wait, you think they are one?
Yeah,
and
they're. I think Cincinnati.
Who's the guy?
Cincinnati. Yeah, that's the first. I think that kicks off the playoff. Saturday at 3:30.
You know what would suck though is if Cincinnati gets what happened with Carson Palmer. You know, they go into Palmer's second year. They kick it around the whole season. I mean, like, that was a good team with him. What was it? Chad Johnson at the time.
Ushman Zada was good.
Ushman Zada. Chris Henry.
Chris Henry.
Before the accident.
Yes.
Cedric Benson wasn't there at the time. They had a good running.
Rudy Johnson.
Rudy Johnson and Chris Perry, former Michigan great. You're welcome on the show anytime, Chris. But you get to that, what was it, the first series of the game? Palmer tears his ACL. And then Pittsburgh goes on to win the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Palmer doesn't tear his ACL there. I don't think Pittsburgh gets out of that game.
Weren't they leading at the time?
It was, I thought it was fairly, I don't even know if they had, I thought it was like first series or whatever it was really early. Like, it just buckled him for that game. He came back too early.
Yep.
See, that's the thing. When there should, it's all, the fans, lay off these guys who are injured, please. You're ruining people's careers by yelling at them and telling them to come back and telling them they're sissies for not coming back from injuries. When they come back too early, your star is going to be inept and terrible. Look at, take for instance, let's look at Dante Culpepper. You talk about coming back from the sex boat incident and the knee injury too soon. I mean, the guy was in rehab. He tore all three ligaments in his knee. He comes back too early and it's a disaster. He's an MVP in the UFL, for Christ's sake.
The worst fans for this, for the quarterbacks, Cutler. Chicago fans with Cutler.
I love Cutler.
Well, we both do. We both can agree with that. But Bears fans hate this guy. And they went, what, 1-5 in his absence? They beat the lowly Vikings. I mean,
whoa.
I'm sorry. Toby Gerhardt and Christian Ponder. I mean, anyway, but, I mean, just right there, you can see what a quarterback will do for you. Regardless, it was Caleb Haney, and, you know, they pulled off Josh McCown from coaching high school football, but which he was doing. They showed him in the headset during
maybe the Cardinals are going to come knocking at your door, retired high school, or coaching baseball in high school. Replace Albert.
You have to talk to my softball manager, Brian Borsch, about taking me off first base.
There's going to have to be a buyout. So, you're going to be like one of those Japanese guys.
Yeah.
They're going to have to negotiate for your rights to negotiate.
Me. Yeah. But then Borsch would get that $55 million, whatever it be.
Borsch doesn't get shit.
And by the way, is there anything more ridiculous than these Japanese players getting essentially bought for, I mean, you have to pay this money just to negotiate them. If they don't accept, you don't get the player and that money's gone.
Yeah, you've only seen really, well, you saw what happened with Daisuke and the Red Sox when that happened.
Well, my question is, why can't they just go into the draft?
Because they're not American. They weren't here. That's the American. Same thing with, like, those, you know.
The Hispanics?
Yeah. You have to get those rights, like you saw Aroldis, you know. I mean, no, that's stupid.
Go ahead.
No, it's just stupid. 57 million for this new guy. What's his name again?
Danish or something?
Yeah, something like that.
Darvish.
Darvish. You Darvish.
Yeah. Danish is a weird guy.
You say so. Not a fan of Danishes. But, there's only been one really successful Japanese. I mean, you can talk about the Kazmatsu and all that, but Ichiro's about it.
What about Hideo Nomo?
For 1 year, for 2 years.
Wait, which 1 year are you saying? With Dodgers?
Yeah.
Well, he had a no-hitter with the Red Sox.
He had a no-hitter. So did Bud Smith with the Cardinals. What are you trying to say?
I'm trying to say Hideo Nomo was one of my boyhood heroes.
Yeah.
Hideki Matsui, don't forget about him.
Yeah.
Yeah, but in general, they're a failure for the most part. I mean, for how much you're paying, you're better off just going through the draft. I mean, how many World Series have been won because of the Japanese guy? And I wouldn't even say Hideki Matsui was the reason they won that.
He was an MVP.
They would have replaced him with some other guy.
Some other Japanese guy?
I mean, it's again. Probably. But they could have. The Yankees could have signed somebody else to fill that spot. I mean, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah, I suppose.
But, I don't know where, the game, like, where do you think baseball stands right now? Sorry.
They need steroids back. They need a lot of steroids to be back. I mean, I don't know. It just,
some people hate to say it, but it's true.
The game never, I mean, game hasn't evolved that much.
No. The game hasn't evolved. Everybody says the pitching's better, just like they say quarterbacking is better now. I think it's because I think it's more a case of, like in football, the quarterbacking is up because defenses are not able to do as much. In baseball, pitching is up because you're not able to take steroids anymore. And,
right.
Because the game wants to be, there's so many people complain about how long games go now. It's getting sped up by worse umpiring, by calling more strikes and stuff. That benefits pitchers getting outside corner and stuff. I don't see a young guy that I'm really drastically impressed with as far as somebody that can carry the game of baseball into the, like, the stratosphere was in the late 90s. Like, Sosa and McGuire were such, McGuire didn't have much of a personality, but Sosa brought that the best out of him. Bonds, Griffey, Ken Caminiti, God rest his soul. I mean, yeah, who's gonna be that next guy? Albert's done it, but, I mean, really.
Albert, yeah, what a fraud.
This coming from somebody who got to celebrate two World Series, and also, might I remind you, before the Cardinals even got to the playoffs, I asked you, point blank, hey Matt, would you have a, hypothetically, if the Cardinals win the World Series, and Albert happens to, leave and take all the money after winning, would you be upset if he took the money and went somewhere else?
No.
And you said, no, not at all.
I'm not upset that he went somewhere else. It's the fact that he's full of shit as far as what he was saying, that he says people, you know, if you think I'm going to leave for money, you don't know me. He's saying, why even say all that shit? He obviously didn't care that much.
Name me one guy that said, in the history of sports, that said, hey, I left somewhere to take the money.
No. I'm saying before he left.
Right.
That's why he left, though.
Yeah. But again, how many people have said? How many people have said that?
I don't.
I mean,
I haven't counted.
I know, but it. I'm going to tell you right now, it's zero. And it's the same thing as when somebody gets asked, "Hey, did you take steroids?" No.
He left because his feelings were hurt.
That, why were his feelings hurt?
Because when.
Okay. Oh, because of his age.
No. Oh, no, no, no. Well, that's it. They restarted their contract negotiations and everything, and, you know, they said, since they got to the offseason, they restarted, and the first contract offer was like 5 or 6 years.
Right.
And for that, he just said he wasn't going to deal with him anymore, and that's why, you know, Angels showed him, he said he really felt wanted by the Angels, because the owner called him, and convinced him to stay. Well, Stan Musial called him too and said that he should stay so he could be the greatest Cardinal of all time. But apparently that's not good enough for Albert.
Well, Stan,
he had to be wine and dine.
Stan's kind of old. Yeah. Stan
Musial owner of his money. I mean, congratulations.
Well, would you rather get. Okay. Matt, if you're getting called by some guy from a retirement home
who
barely has anything left in the can that's about to die, and he's calling you and saying, hey Matt, I want you to go ahead and be my best friend for the last couple of weeks of my life. Or if some rich millionaire, like if Mark Cuban comes up to you and starts whining and dining you, what are you going to say? I'm guessing you're going to say...
Either way, he's getting money though from the Cardinals or the Angels. You know what I mean? If that's a completely different, getting a call from a guy in a nursing home, are you serious? You're joking, right?
Bet you Stan Musial's in a retirement home right now.
I doubt it. He's probably got personal home care.
I'm not 90, but I think if I had personal home care right now, I don't think I'd have a reason to leave the house.
No.
I
don't have personal home care right now, and I don't want to leave the house.
No, it's not. No, I hate. No, it sucks. I mean, take for instance, I go to Christmas shopping. That was tough. This year was by far the worst. That's why I paid your sister last year to do my shopping for me. That was You talk about laziness. That was dead at a T. But can you blame somebody for doing that? Because I had the wrapping, I don't mind. But Christmas has gotten so bogged down with this situation of, I mean, it's not even a holiday anymore. Like, I could care less if I got any of the gifts I got. I'm not saying I don't appreciate any of them, but I'm just saying, like, there's no meaning. Like, you tell somebody what you want, they get it. I mean, that's not Christmas. Christmas is, you get disappointed by gifts that you didn't want,
right,
and you throw them away or return to the store the next day. It's not, hey, I want this year's Sports Illustrated swimsuit edition, and wham bam, it's wrapped, or it's in the stocking.
Is that what you asked for?
I've asked for my subscription back. We got taken away by my parents, but I'd say there's no meaning behind it. And when I'll tell you what, Kmart, by far, the worst experience Christmas shopping ever. There's no organization.
First of all, that's your fault for going to Kmart. You can't.
It's all about location.
You already know you don't like Kmart, so why'd you go there?
I didn't know that it was going to be that bad. I hadn't been there in two and a half years.
I haven't been there for 2.5 years either. I'm still ain't going back to shop there, especially for Christmas. Okay, let's continue.
Okay. First, there's no organization. There's no candy. That's the one thing that pisses me off.
Candy?
Right.
What candy?
I have gotten in a habit of buying a big bag of either Reese's Pieces or peanut butter M&Ms. And no big bag.
Yeah, they do.
No,
you
not
find them.
I was in the candy aisle. I was in the candy aisle, roaming the candy aisle for a good 20 minutes. I looked like an idiot. And walking around that store, there's no organization. Like, sporting goods and fishing stuff are like camping separate. I mean, that's all sporting goods. That should all be in the same niche, old neck of the woods.
Kmart is
the homeless man's Walmart.
No, they need to they need to figure out what they are.
Right.
They need to pick something.
And not to mention that whole Sears giveaway. Did that end? Because
I have no idea.
Because you're supposed to. Well, when I used to go there, it was, if you're at Kmart, you're going to get offered at the end of your shopping. You go to the cash register, and there's a clear sign that says, hey, if you don't get offered a Sears gift card or a credit card, you get a free 2-liter pop.
Yeah.
Well, I go to that line, and I'm waiting. I had never gotten the opportunity. I'd always been offered. And as soon as I got done checking out, I have my bag, and I'm like, free 2-liter. I was going to offer a Sears card. She said, no, I did. And then the manager sided with the employee. How much bullshit is that?
It was funny, one time when I was working there.
I still ask for my 2-liter to this day.
Yeah.
It's a 2-liter pop. I'm not, well, maybe with Kmart, I'm bankrupting the place, but
when I was 16, I didn't ask somebody, and somebody says, where's my 2-liter? I'm like, okay. So all I did was, I just went back to the pantry section. I got a 2-liter pie. So what kind they want? I just gave it to him. Like, there you go. Just be on your way. Don't tell anybody. There you go.
Well, my question is there a place that's easier to rob? I don't think like.
Than Kmart?
Yeah. I mean, even Walmart. Like, Walmart. Well, you got the
old people.
Yeah,
the greeters.
Yeah, that is some of my favorites.
It's like well, Randy Marsh's dad in South Park.
It's like that, and it's also like the racial profiling and the airlines do, where they start like, they're like, they'll only bot cavity search people that are not white. You know?
Yeah.
Because the white people, I mean, white people just get pissed off. I mean, you're classical white guy, white people problems, where if you get searched, your bag searched and checked, and your receipt checked, they're like,
you're weak.
You're gonna get pissed off. You're gonna get surly. If if you're not white, I think it just turns into kind of a natural thing. Like, you're expecting, I mean, you're expecting to get searched. It pisses you off, but, I mean, it's stupid, but it happens. And, back to the Cardinals. Sorry about the, we had to go back to Matt's old stomping grounds.
Stomping grounds.
Yeah. The
Angels. People still ask me, by the way, if I work at Kmart. Also, speaking of, okay, you want to go back to pool? Okay,
hold on. This is going to be good. Let's hear this.
No. So the day Pujols signed with the Angels,
right?
It was like at 9 a.m. or something that everybody found out. I had texts from people I hadn't heard from for a few years. Numbers I didn't have.
Right.
Like saying, "Hey, are you okay? I'm sorry for your loss."
Yeah.
Or like, and I'm fine. Yeah. I'm looking at this. I'm like, I feel like somebody like in my family has died or. Something terrible happened to me.
Like the time when I got a bunch of text messages from players saying that they were sorry that my dad died and he didn't.
Yeah, I don't know where they... Yeah, something like that. But, yeah. I mean, if that was me probably when I was like 15, 16, 17...
There would have been a definite batch of fuck you text messages sent there.
Yeah. Yeah, I probably would have turned my phone off and cried or something, but... No, I can deal with it.
Well, it's really a sign of the times, the evolution of Matt Shepard.
Yeah.
I mean, let's go back.
As far as a fan.
Yeah, let's go back. We're going to go back to the annals of history a little bit here. First off, back in, Jock Jones was with the Cubs. And this would have been maybe 06, maybe. He hits a home run against the Cardinals. And... Sunday Night Baseball, and they go up, it was like a 3-run home run. Doesn't matter. Cardinals were put away at that point. Yeah, I make a phone call over to the Shepherd household. No answer. Sure, it was a screen for who was on the phone. And, we get a, call a couple more times. No answer.
Yeah.
Finally, I call again. And I just get a frightening response. If you ever call here fucking again, I'll kill you. Hang up. Click.
Was it me?
It was you. Oh, it was without a doubt you. Because unless I called the wrong number. Which I don't think so.
I'm sure you've had that response to you when somebody answered the phone more than that.
No, right? It's mostly women. But
yeah.
Mostly women. And then, I think it would have been probably the same year. Cardinals, or it would have been Colts playoff game versus Patriots.
AFC championship game, yeah.
Colts
was in 21-3 at half.
Right, and there was a chair thrown, Bobby Knight style, thrown to the ground.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
The rolling chair in the living room, that was
okay.
At least pushed to the ground in fury.
Okay.
After a dramatic Tom Brady touchdown romp.
Yeah.
Then... You're walking upstairs, and I crack a smile. You had to have had eyes in the back of your head at that point. Hey, if you think this is fucking funny, you get the hell out. I didn't talk the rest of the evening. I was left by myself with you in the house.
Yeah, my family went across the street to watch a game with them because they couldn't be there with me, right?
Right.
But you decided to stick behind with me, right?
I don't know why.
Yeah.
It almost felt like a death sentence.
And you watched. You watched a couple of Cardinal Worlds. You watched a World Series loss with me this year too, and I was okay.
Oh yeah.
See.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it shows. Well, in this whole season with the Peyton Manning thing, you would have cried. You would have cried. Albert Peyton.
Yeah, I know.
I mean,
it would have been traumatic. It was
traumatic
3 years ago.
There would have been
6 years ago.
There would have been. Bodies underneath. There would have been bodies in the closet. Skeletons in the closet of Matt Shepard.
Yeah.
And, yeah, I don't. What's up with that, huh? When are we going to see this? The fury. Where are we? Is that.
I don't think so. I mean,
he's dead and gone.
I think I'm slowly growing. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is.
I have a theory.
That's how they get.
So when you're young, you're a fan, you're diehard, Yeah. You carry that with you for a while. It's hard to shake it. But then there's the losers that keep it with them for too long. Like, I don't know. It's like a guy like hanging on to. It's like a guy with a comb over.
Fireman Ed.
Yeah, the guy that coins. He's the Fireman Ed's the classic guy with three strands of hair to use as a comb over, and. You know the guy's bald. The guy doesn't want to admit he's bald. He should just get a toupee or wear a hat.
Yep.
And Fireman Ed is a classic example of he can't let it go. Now he's got some pubs.
Well, don't get me wrong. I couldn't watch SportsCenter for like a month or a month and a half after the Colts lost to the Saints.
Oh, well. Yeah, but at least they had hurt Katrina. Like, at least that was the talk. If the Jets won, it would have been all about Fireman Ed.
Well, I'm just talking about the Colts loss on the Jets winning the Saints.
Yeah.
I'm just talking about them. And speaking of...
Is there anybody that you hate more as a fan of Fireman Ed?
Oh, I don't definitely. Think. Definitely.
You hate more?
Somebody else, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure I do.
I mean...
He was getting pissed me off during the World Series. He showed Nolan Ryan every other pitch. Oh, like Rangers-Cardinals series. Every other time, is any non-player personality? You know, non-person.
He has no personality.
Well, and what was best of now? I don't know. He just, you know, like guys like that just need to shut up. You're not playing. I get that you're your own part owner, whatever you are, but that Nolan Ryan pissed me off. Who else did he show? Rob Ryan for the Cowboys get show.
Yeah, I hate the guys behind the scenes that get seen too much. And the guys that aren't good and aren't, like, they're not, it's the whole, I mean, we just created a society of a-holes who decide, a couple guys, I mean, of course, like, why are the Jets so big name now? Because they got a big, fat, and loudmouth coach.
Right.
And they got an organization that likes to sign guys for publicity. They're trying to be like the Cowboys to compete with the Giants. They're not going to beat the Giants ever.
So let me get this straight. Here on the Bob Sullivan Show, Bob Sullivan Nation, you can drop F-bombs. You've dropped two so far. But you said a-holes. Now, how does this work on the Bob Sullivan Show? I mean, I understand you're not here at the moment, but for the first... I don't know how long I've been doing this. For the first 50 minutes or 45 minutes, you're doing okay. But what happened?
I don't know. I don't know. But it was just, heat of the moment.
I guess I'm pretty impressed that you said any holes and that. But
no.
But you dropped the F-bomb all you want.
No, this portion of the show is probably going to be sponsored by, like, Teletubbies. I can't be dropping F bombs and C bombs. I gotta clean it up for the children out there that maybe their parents are letting them listen.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the last 10 minutes. Like so or so that they can listen to.
Yeah, we got about 9 minutes left, 10 minutes left, so.
But yeah, it's
what do you think of the first show so far, Bobby? What do you think where are you going with this year? I mean, I kind of went off on a little couple different things here, but
It was fun.
Yeah,
I think we. I don't know. It's definitely a. I think it's a foundation. I think there's been a couple bricks laid for the foundation.
Sure, sure.
The concrete probably hasn't been poured yet, but I don't know. I think there's a. There's definitely some room for improvement. There's definitely got to be the a-holes discussing Matt Leinart and USC quarterback
John David Booty.
There's definitely too much mentioning of
Seneca Wallace.
Yeah, random athletes. We need to clean that up a little.
But what do you think was the most random one you mentioned in this short time today? John David Booty.
Yeah. Probably. Yeah. I don't know. I mean, it's probably a good thing that when I compared him to Sean Salisbury, he didn't go into that.
Yeah, his whole incident and why he got fired by ESPN.
Yeah, and I don't know. What do we do? Well, as far as what direction should I go with this? I mean, I've got limitless topics I can talk about.
Right.
I'm highly opinionated, which can offend people. Should I stick with the mildly offensive, or should I go to a no offensive format? I don't know. I mean, I'm interviewing these athletes.
Yeah, you gotta say, you gotta stay professional.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you're doing a pretty good job besides the, like I said, those couple mm-hmm. F-drops, but, you know, you'll figure it out. And yeah. I'm pretty impressed that there's only two.
Right. And, well, two that we know of.
Two that we know of. I think it was two.
Yeah, I think we got some, how do I say it? Some traction. I want to know what you people think out there. I care about the people. I'm a man of the people. And so whenever you listen to this, maybe you're going to listen to 5 minutes. Whatever. Whatever you listen to, we appreciate whatever viewers, the listeners you get. Whatever. If you think it sucks, let me know. if you want to suck
for a... If you think it really sucks?
Yeah.
If you want to suck for a t-shirt?
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe we do an email segment? Like reader emails, answer questions.
If we get enough.
Matt's mailbag?
Matt's mailbag.
Would Matt's mailbag be
Matt's mailbag. Yeah, we can do that.
I mean, we just gotta build this thing.
Yeah.
And, the way I got this idea, it's just, I don't know, I got tired of local radio. Really, Todd and Tyler, they're good. I'll listen to them. Well, I listen to, you know, ESPN 1620. But other than that, really, it's bad. Local radio is pretty bad. And I got fed up with it. I decided, what the hell? If I lose out in viewers to Pat and JT in the morning on Q98.5, so be it. No one wants us. I mean, it's basically the unwanted interviews that you want to hear.
Yeah.
Basically.
If you want John David Booty references.
If you want John David Booty references.
Or Houston Texans football.
You want Mike Novak. You want to hear Mike Novak's career going. What I want to do is interview these athletes I know that are playing at college, small colleges that maybe you can't follow.
Yeah.
I'll post their stats. Have an all Bob team, have whatnot, women's basketball, whatever you play, let me know.
It's the first brick of
many to be
the foundation.
Yeah, it's one of many to be laid.
Well, it was fun, Bob.
Well, Matt Shepard, thank you for being on the first ever Bob Sullivan Show. The Bob Sullivan Show.
Hopefully it's not the only. Hopefully it's not the only one. Yeah. Only show. If it's not the only show,
it's
not my only appearance.
Yeah, if it's the only show, thanks. And, you know, I think I can safely say this on air, Matt Shepard will be a regular on the show.
Wow.
Monday morning Matt.
Monday morning Matt.
But it'll probably be posted mid-afternoon, late evening.
Yeah.
So.
But it'll be...
It'll be Mondays.
Yeah, Mondays.
Monday Matt.
Monday mailbag night.
Yes. We're going to do...
No, man.
Yep. Well, if they're... Yeah, we'll ask questions to Matt. So, yeah. Thank you for listening, and hit me up. Thank you. Bye.